Welcome back to Whisper Gaming ASMR. Today we are once again playing Deep Rock Galactic, and we have two more missions left to complete for the 5-year anniversary assignment. So, point extraction, I think, is usually a pretty quick mission type. We'll see. I've never done it solo, so we might do two missions in this playthrough. We'll see. Let's see. Do I have a lot of this to sell? Yeah, I can sell 60 of that. I will take the deal. Nice. Okay. See if there's any good special beers on tap. More markite. That does not apply to this mission, but we will grab a free glyphid slammer. Okay. And my nice supporters mug that I bought for getting the first round of supporters DLC a couple years ago. This is one game where I will pay for cosmetics because there's not many of them. I think they have maybe 5 different cosmetic options or packages you can buy, and they're like between $10 and $15. So a couple years ago I bought, I might have actually bought it on sale for like $8. But it had like gold skins for all the weapons and gold armor and stuff like that. But I really like this development team. I think it's called Ghost Ship. So I want to support them. And they just came out with a new supporters cosmetic pack that looks pretty cool. Considering buying it, we'll see. It's $15. So maybe if I stick with this game, I'll buy it. But again, I go through phases of playing it. But if you haven't seen the previous videos, that's totally fine. So this game, you are a dwarf in space working for a mining company called Deep Rock Galactic. And you're sent down on these different missions in these, I guess, drop pods. And you have to collect different resources or complete different objectives while trying not to die, because there are hostile aliens called glyphids that are kind of like bugs. And then there are other hazards as well. So up here is, I don't know if I'd call it a mini boss. Oh shit, I overheated. But this is one of the, it's bigger than just the normal. So those are the grunts, those are kind of just like the normal run-of-the-mill mobs. And then you have the Praetoriate, which is a larger version that's more dangerous. And then there's some even bigger ones that you occasionally encounter if you're unlucky. But I'm playing on a pretty low difficulty, so we should be fine. This cave looks kinda big, though. Okay, so those blue things, like over here, I'm gonna need to go mine those and bring them back. I think you pronounce it Aquarius. I have 7 Aquarius I have to get. It looks like Bosco's doing the mining for me. How nice of him. Oh wow, he can even carry it, so I'm not used to playing solo, so I don't really know all of Bosco's. Oh shit. I don't know all of Bosco's capabilities. Well, let's see, I will. And I can hear some monsters. Okay, I think there's one up there. Let's see if he gets it. Oh crap. classes. So there's five different difficulty levels, and I am currently playing on the second to lowest, so it shouldn't be too hard. Okay, so he'll straight up bring the chorus back. Looks like he won't put it inside the, inside the whatever, the depositor. Okay, let's see, go get that one then, Bosco. Bosco's a pretty cool companion. And I will try to find, so I have a secondary objective to find these type of fossils, which I don't exactly know how I'm gonna get up to that one. Then you have this red crystal, it's called red sugar, that's how you replenish your health. And then you have this nitro, which is how you replenish your resources. So if you run out of ammo, or since I'm the driller, I have these drills. If it runs out of gas or fuel, I need to call in a supply pod to resupply, obviously. Nice. Bosco's very helpful on this mission type, apparently. I wish he could grab those fossils, though. Let's see. Where would more fossils be? I guess I can get a few of these on my own without Bosco. There's a plane flying overhead, or someone's playing music loud. Sorry, it's kind of my trademark in my videos to comment on the loud stuff going on. I have a pretty good recording environment for New York City, but it's definitely not ideal. There's still some sounds, especially since I've been recording more videos in the morning recently. Oh, there must be... Those things come from like a breeder. Oh no, oh no. Thank God, I thought I was gonna die. Oh, those aren't good. Okay, I gotta drill my way back up. Oh, these things also explode. That's kind of fun. That I need. And it's so much darker playing solo, because typically you have four dwarves, so you have four times the flares. And there's four different classes, so you typically have one of each, or at least three of the four. And one of them is the scout, which has a flare gun that they shoot a flare into the wall and it lights up a big area for a while. So not having that makes it much darker. Okay, Bosco, bring me the Aquarius. Okay, now I need to find... Well, Bosco, mine that. See if I can find some that are more accessible. See, maybe I can drill my way up there. was the Scout, which I was thinking about picking, but I thought I was going to have to do a lot of drilling. I didn't realize that Bosco could just collect the Aquarius for me. Chance I'm gonna fall. It's either ground to my death while doing this. That's why I like playing with real people, because, okay, so I need to go further up. Okay, how did I, where did I drill? Basically need to go up, okay. When you play with real people, you can get revived as many, there's no limit to how many times you can get revived, as long as at least one person stays alive. And there's no, like, timer either, so you stay downed indefinitely until Bosco, you're supposed to be keeping an eye on that. Okay, I need to make sure I don't fall to my death. It's gonna be a little tricky. Uh-oh. This might not be the best place to encounter a swarm. Secondary objective that much on this one. I just want to get this done and we'll finish up the assignment. I typically do the secondary ones, but you know what? We got the main objective done. Things are basically like the creepers in this game. Okay, let's just get the heck out of here. I'm not gonna fail a level 2 mission. Good enough. Now, there's gonna be a drop pod that I have to make it to. can't remember if the drop pod lands right where I am, or if I still have to go find it somewhere. Does this rain make this thing overheat faster, or is that just because I held it for so long? Usually it shows where the drop pod's gonna land, so that's why I'm wondering if it just can't, it definitely can't fit here to land though. Might as well go mine that gold while we wait. Exploders. And there's giant ones too that are very scary. But I can imagine those don't spawn very often on this difficulty. Oh shit. This isn't too much to worry about since I'm pretty close already. I'm a driller, so I can just dig through the ground, but sometimes it's quite a mad dash to get back to the drop pod. Which even if you complete the mission but you don't make it back to the drop pod, you fail. Oh, there's an exploder. Well, not a complete success, but at least not a total failure. I'll consider that a win. Good enough. My upstairs neighbors are now banging around. Not too annoying. I don't know what they're doing up there. So this one's a drill dozer mission. I think maybe I will switch to gunner for this one. Terrain require one less pickaxe hit. Might as well. I like to tip the old robot bartender. He also looks extra fancy for this anniversary event. Just missed. I suck. There we go. Well caught. Well, end on a win. Okay. This mission type is a little bit involved. Low oxygen. That's gonna be kind of annoying. Are there any other? Okay, I gotta do that one, I guess. Golden bugs. I've never done this mission type with low oxygen modifier before. we'll see how it goes. If we can do the secondary mission, we'll do it. If not, I'm fine with just completing the primary mission for this one. That fuel later. Oh, my O2 is dropping. Okay, Molly gives the oxygen. Okay, that shouldn't be too bad. Oh, speaking of mining, I learned some pretty depressing facts last night about mining. Not sure if this is a good topic for ASMR videos, but basically all the cobalt in our batteries and electronics and everything are pretty much mined by like child slaves in the Congo, well, and adult slaves as well, like people that make a dollar a day and are digging mines by hand. That there's like cave-ins every week, and it's just terrible living conditions to power all of our electronics. And I watched, I can't remember the guy's name, I think Siddharth something. But I think the name of his book is Cobalt Red, where he talks about it. I haven't read the book, I just watched his interview. But pretty eye-opening stuff. I don't really know what to do with that information, since it's really hard to not use electronics, and I don't know how much, I don't think I personally can have much of an impact on mining regulation and things like that, but I guess I'm glad that I'm aware of it, even though it is depressing, and hopefully more people being aware of it will help some change happen, because it's pretty bad that most of our electronics come from inhumane mining practices, and then they're also not assembled the most humanely, since I don't think China and the other countries that our electronics are manufactured have the best labor laws. So again, not much I can do personally, but with the small reach I have on this channel, I guess I can spread a little bit of awareness, and at some point when enough people know, hopefully something will change. So yeah, don't want to get too dark and depressing, since this is supposed to be a relaxing video, but the mining just made me think of that. And I watched it right before I went to bed last night, so I had very weird dreams. So, on a lighter note, I got a new bookshelf that I ordered almost 2 weeks ago, finally got delivered yesterday, and I started putting it together. I spent about 3 hours building it last night, which I'm pretty good at putting together furniture from like IKEA and Wayfair, but god, that thing took so much time. So I still need to finish it up. I was working on it at night and didn't want to be too loud to my downstairs neighbors. But yeah, so hopefully we'll have a new bookshelf today. I'm finish it up after I finish up this video and do a little bit of work for my actual job. Stop beating up Molly, I gotta deposit this nitra. She's getting beat up pretty bad. Oh no. I wish she had a gun. Get away from Doretta. See how this goes. Completely forgot I'm supposed to be looking for those. Oh crap, how do I get up to that? Also, what is this? Is this a new resource? What is this? Bitter gem. I don't know if I've seen that before. Can sometimes be a pain to gather. Hopefully they make it a little bit easier for one person. Oh, I wonder if I can have Bosco mine this, because sometimes it's just out of range of the laser, and that's when it gets really annoying if you don't have a scout or someone. Oxygen modifier. Luckily, it hasn't been too much of an issue so far. I'm gonna be just short, I think. Like a mini event. get back to try to... Shit. Oh my. Is that a thing to get two of those events? Seems like it's always the last one you mine. I don't know if that's by design or I've just got unlucky. Oh, nice. Okay, I guess I just got unlucky. I wonder if I can, set Bosco. Mine those fragments for me. That'd be very convenient. Okay, there's only two. Oh, maybe that's why I got it, because there's only two fragments. Or is there another one? Okay. And hope he will not mine it. And a trophy, so I'll get double experience for this. So you don't get, well, I guess you do get burnt. My shoulder just cracked. Something for work, since I have to start my actual job soon. This is not ideal placement, but we'll make it work. Thank you. seems like you take decreased burn damage while you're like interacting with stuff. Oh crap. There's a lot of different things for me to remember right now. I forgot this gun. It can explode the poison gas at the Praetorian's drop. I miss having a full team of people. More work on your own. I wonder if Bosco can do repairs. Nope. Probably resupply before I leave this area as well. I have plenty of nitro. Or maybe I can wait a little bit. I still have a decent amount of resources. There's no deposit thing on the drill dozer. You think there'd be a way to deposit on it? Okay. Let's get rolling. Hopefully this takes us straight to the final event without any more stops. And it's going to be interesting on my own as well, because there's a lot going on, and usually it takes a team effort, so hopefully it's dumbed down a bit. I like that you can pet Toddy. I don't want to spoil how the end of this mission, how this mission ends, but there's a tradition that real dwarves in this game do at the end of this mission type. Yeah, I'm not even gonna deal with the secondary objective at this point. I just wanna get this thing done with. getting close. I would think. There it is. That's what we're after. Resources. Let's take a look around really quick and then start this thing up. Hurry up with that mineral. Money, but might as well call down a couple. Where the heck is Bosco? There you are. Whoa, okay, that could have just ended very bad. Probably wait for Bosco to get back, but you know what? I want to get this thing over with. Oh yeah, I did a poll recently on my channel asking for what length video people preferred, and it seems like around 45 minutes is the top choice. I mean, only 8 people voted, but still. And then around 20 to 30 minutes was the second, so... yeah, this video should be a little over 45 minutes, so hopefully you all like that. Okay, Bosco, where are you? Where's Molly? There you are. Yep. This is when it's nice to have multiple people so you can repair and destroy these rocks at the same time. At least they seem to be coming at a slower rate than typically. Usually there's a ton of them. Only 2, maybe 3 flying rocks. Is there gonna be one more? Okay, they did make this a lot. A lot less difficult. It's so dark in here, I can't see anything. So far, so good. Sidearm action. We're almost. almost home free. Oh yeah, now we have these lasers. Don't seem to do as much damage as usual. But yeah, if you haven't played this game, I highly recommend you play it. Especially with other people. Even like, the community's amazing. Everyone's super nice. Well, maybe not everyone, but 99% of the people you're gonna play with are gonna be nice, from my experience. Discord community, I'm not super involved, but when I check them out, seems like a good group of people, and it's very fun to play, even with randoms. It doesn't really require voice chat to coordinate, because you have this thing that you can tag things with, and you can do text chat, and most things can be communicated with a rock and stone. So, can I take this out? Objective for this game. Oh no. There it is. You don't get any bonus for this, but it's tradition to bring Dreda's head back with you. See if we can ride Dreda all the way back to the drop pod. I mean, Molly, too many robots with female names. Nope, freaking Molly. Oh crap. Cover us, Bosco. Oh no. Where's Dreda's head? That's one of the real bad guys. I'm sorry, Dreda. I might have to leave you behind. I can't die to this thing. There you are. Oh, that's the first time we've seen an oppressor in one of these videos. Run, run, run. Oh no! I forgot about oxygen. Oh crap. What happens? Excitement added to that ending, but we got Dreda. That's all that matters. And we completed the anniversary. anniversary assignment, so all in all, very happy with how this turned out. Nice. Play cards. I think I unlocked a company script, let's see. Nice. New Matrix Core. Oh, I get the 5-year party hat and then some resources. Claim some perk points. I can start a new assignment after this and let's see. Script. So now I can either. I don't really like how that bulldog one looks. I don't really use the Subnautica though. Yeah, that one looks kind of lame compared to the one I have. We'll do this one. My trailer so I can keep getting experience with them, but then there's all these new weapons to unlock as well. The coil gun seems pretty cool. Yeah, I'll do the coil gun. Okay, well, I will leave it there. Glad we finally completed that. The anniversary event ended in 2 days, so we got it done just in time. And also, I'm up to 35 subscribers at the time of recording this, so thank you so much if you are one of them. If you are not, a like or comment, or especially a subscribe, would be greatly appreciated. If you made it to this point in the video, hopefully you've enjoyed, so yeah, consider liking or subscribing, and any type of comment is appreciated. Most comments, please don't be rude or say anything really bad, but I even appreciate feedback about things I'm doing wrong, because that helps me improve. So yeah, any type of constructive or positive feedback is super appreciated. And I hope you enjoyed this time, and I hope you will come back and join me in the next one. So, hope you've relaxed during this, and have a nice night.